7k gold lead not too long ago, and that gold is slowly starting to diminish as Damwon continue to find these successful fights.
Yeah, I mean, a couple of good fights in a row for Damwon. It's now about 4.5k. As you said, it was 7k earlier, but Matt are at Soul Point. That is kind of what they have bought for themselves. Damwon will have to fight at this Mountain Soul. I don't think you can give it up with this type of composition. Yes, the Azir has high consistent damage, but your other three damage dealers are all very upfront, very burst heavy, and Mountain Soul's really difficult to deal with for those champs. So it becomes about the setup for Matt. We're 3.5 away. They want to make sure that they have full vision control, get out there early, be there a minute in advance, full vision denial, and try to make sure that Khan has no options for TP flanks or for these really surprising angles.
Showmaker just going to poke across the wall here, but you can see Kaiser.
Oh, oh my god.
Hey. He definitely has the damage, Vedius. Just needs to hit those Qs. Showmaker
down to half. Yep, you are correct.
Showmaker not yet got the Seeker's Arm God, not got any armor. Wouldn't do too much against Cerilda.
That's a 3.5 item. Yeah. Yeah, that's a lot of lethality into Armit's back pocket. And when playing into no armor, yeah, it hurts, as you can see.
Now, oh man, Showmaker looking like a range minion out there.
Also want to note,
Armut, he's got to find Khan and chase him around and look for the 1v1. Make the Ken use his ultimate in the 1v1 or back off from that position. Because Armut is committing to trying to land poke on the four-man squad, no one is marking Kennen. Kennen finds the angle, and that was all she wrote for this team fight, and that is such a huge error from Mad Lions. The question now is, can you actually get the Mountain Soul? Because Damwon have reset pretty late. Oh my god, the damage done. That tells the whole story.
It really does. Shockwave from Humanoid did land, but Khan just slicing and tearing through Mad. Now, Dragon started up. It will be the Soul. Humanoid TPing behind here. Khan doesn't have the slicing mouse for a couple more seconds. Mad Lion should be able to secure the Mountain Soul at least, but Humanoid is in no man's land. Caught by himself, Khan pops the stopwatch to stop the shockwave, but Mad Lion's still looking to fight. They are able to get the shutdown. Humanoid will die as well. Canyon on the flank now. Kazi, no bullet time. Quickness almost back up for Kaiser. Now it comes in. Armor still alive, but Beryl's diving onto him. Showmaker pops the stopwatch of his own. Ghost healing up. Beryl down. Kazi trying to get away, and Showmaker will die as well. And Kazi's still alive, but Canyon will take him out. Elioya and Kaiser versus Ghost and Canyon. And then Elioya tries to get away, but the Deadly Flourish finds his mark once again. He dodges the Shockwave. Kaiser gets the heal with Gleaming Quill and will dodge back. Canyon, no Dragon's Rage, no Sonic Wave connecting. Ends up being a 3-for-3 trade.
Wow. So, another massive fight takes place. Mad Lions will walk away with the Soul, but Damwon should be able to continue their siege. They're not going to overcommit. Instead, they're going to keep pushing in these waves, get a couple more towers down, and now look at this. The gold dead even. This is why Damwon is the reigning world champions and why they are one of the favorites to win the whole thing.
Absolutely. I mean, they're so damn good at playing out the mid and the late game. That is really where they do excel. The Shockwave does get Zonias there. And you know, honestly, at the end of the day, this is not that bad for Mad Lions in this specific play because they did come away with the Mountain Soul. They're trading even on kills. Yes, that play by Baron was catastrophic. That let Damwon back in the game. But you are still now even on gold, and you have Mountain Soul. And that is very, very powerful against Damwon's comp. That is very much so an upfront damage type of style.
Whew. So now we're in a position where...
See, Canyon will clear it out. Kazi gets the slow, but Canyon, obviously on the Lee Sin, can just dodge away.
Look, they even move Ghost off onto a side lane, and then because they have the Azir turret here, they know that it's that much harder for a Kaiser engage to come through alongside a Jarvan. So Damwon just continuing to play the map. They have actually gotten themselves the gold lead. I think that's the first time this game. But the fact that they've been able to claw back from the deficit that they're in, just so impressive. And I can't get over how they played that Baron, because like we were talking so much about it, Azel, very much about how they need this cannon to get onto the back line.
Yeah.
So you need a flank. So, well, but how do they do that? When you don't have mid prior, when you don't have control, how are you going to get this deep vision into a flank? Well, you force them into a fight on your terms. You decide when the fight happens. And to have that awareness and then...
The Zenith blade from chasing him down, but Canyon once again gets the kick, knocks Humanoid back, and Humanoid dies. Elioya trying to get onto the back line. Canyon and Beryl are low here. Canyon still has the GA. Showmaker caught up in the Cataclysm. Beryl will get killed off by Kazi, and Mad Lions may have found a
gun
here. But Khan is having none of it. Pops the stopwatch, slices through Mad Lions. Khan, in his last worlds, doesn't even want to lose a game. He will kill off the Mad Lions as Damwon march through mid.
Time and time again, Khan coming up huge with these team fight ultimates. and Damwon on the march to victory here in game two.
Wow, an insane comeback from Damwon. They have the wave. Only Kaiser is alive.
No,
he's gonna be shut down. Canyon won't lose his life either, and Damwon are going to match point.
There is an aura around Damwon that just seems unstoppable. 2-0 over the Mad Lions.
Showmaker said in live video, we don't lose. And so far it has been true. Here comes Showmaker.
They definitely do.
And to me, this looks like a flash prediction. He's expecting Karzy to flash when the animation comes through. Karzy has the read though, plays it very well. And then Kaiser on point here. The flash coming out from Ghost, but he predicts it right into the MF ulti. And then all hell breaks loose. Everyone TPing in, but look at Humanoid getting so much done on both Khan and Showmaker.
That's a really good observation there. Oh, another engage.
There's the quickness. Ghost caught up in it. The charm comes out and Ghost will fall. One more auto from Kazi is enough.
Now that's a pretty big pick for Matt because Ghost has just invested his TP. Canyon does have the Herald, so he's going to drop that one top and it's just a simple cross map. Damwon going to continue investing money into Khan, as you would very much expect. Meanwhile, Matt trying to get something back on the bot side, but it's only going to be a couple plates as they're not going to be able to take this tower down. And I think that Matt is saying, let's try and stop the second tower siege that could very well come out from Dai.
Yeah, and so much of it is just about this flank. From Armut, able to actually sneak around the backside there of the Baron Pit, finds the ultimate coming through, and then Karzy coming from an unexpected angle here. This MF ulti just absolutely roasts Showmaker and gets Ghost very low.
And then Karzy commits onto Barrel because he's like, that's a lot of gold, and that's 900 into my back pocket. And then you have this incredible collapse. Look, another 600 gold onto Karzy as well. 1.5k off of two kills should bring him, well, to an infinity edge.
Wow.
That was a who tries to find the flank, gets one shot at the start of this fight. Kaiser tries to go in to get something back, and Humanoid and Karzy both commit everything that they have to getting that kill. Armored is split from the rest of the team, and then Mad find themselves in a 3v4.
But you had to think, with Humanoid, oh, they're going for the end here, Alyoya!
Showmaker just does so much damage. Alyoya is down, Armored next up. Damwon here able to take down the inhibitor, and they are looking for the end, as you say, Azale. Undefeated, 9-0, Damwon Kia in the pursuit of perfection. They are found worthy once again, and they will fight T1 in semis.